Hi traders, thanks for stopping by thetradinganalyst.com. This is Taylor and we're going to take a look at a bunch of charts here and I'm going to give my analysis and my thought process and you're going to walk away from this video with some newfound knowledge on technical analysis as well as hopefully some profitable trade ideas based off of this free analysis video that we're about to give you right now. But first, if you're not already a member at thetradinganalyst.com, go ahead and give us a visit on the homepage of the website and get to know us a little bit better. If you like these free videos and analysis that we give to you on a daily basis, it's really nothing in comparison to the membership you get once you sign up with the premium membership. Once you sign up with the premium membership, you're going to get instant access to the profitable trade alerts that our current members are getting and loving on a daily and weekly basis. It's a great opportunity, and we'd love to help you start making some winning trades in the market. All right, so we're going to take a look at this chart here, starting off with Amazon. And Amazon, I want to point out, we're coming into this resistance level. We've been pointing it out right around $1,000, which is right where we closed at. You can clearly see it reacting to this level here several days in a row, almost hit it there. That's where we got rejected last time and then headed lower. And here you can clearly see we're reacting to it. Today we closed pretty much right at that resistance level and we tested these highs. All right, so what you want to look for is if we can get some kind of a continuation of the move tomorrow. If we break today's lows, I think that we can consider this a good short candidate if it breaks the lows of today. So if we break the lows of today, short candidate, that's only if it breaks the lows of this today's candle. All right, so if we end up closing over this resistance again, I think we're going to hit at least 1020. 1020 is going to be that near-term target for Amazon, just because you can see it was resistance here from this big gap down right here. So we'll see kind of how it reacts to it. I've been pointing out for a while now that, you know, we had this big volume selling day followed by another one and another one right here, and we're still below those price points currently. So we really still have to keep that in mind and still factor that in to our trading. If we really hold over about 1020, then I think that's going to lead to a really nice breakout on Amazon. But we still got a lot of work to do. We still got to get over $1,000 here. We'll sustain over $1,000. We're about 93 cents over that. But I really want to see a more sustained move over that to get more bullish. All right, the next one we're going to touch on is Google. And Google, again here, you can clearly see it's reacting to this resistance. This resistance is at about 1,005. You can see right here was previous resistance. Look at how many days in a row it's hitting that level right on and then getting rejected. And then we came up here right there and got rejected right there. And here we are once again reacting to this level right here. We closed at that level yesterday. The close of yesterday was 1,065 and right, I'm sorry, 1,005 and 65 cents. And again, today we're right here, 1,005 and 65 cents again today with a reversal candle. So it doesn't mean we can't break over it, but if we break the lows of, just like Amazon, if we break the lows of today, I think that we're going to see some kind of a retracement lower, okay? Some kind of a retracement lower. I think that the look that we have right now is a much better look than the last time we came up to this level, okay? This time, you know, I was very certain that we were going to get rejected here. Here, not as certain just because of the way we led into that level. And that's because of all this sideways trading created a lot of energy buildup. And I think it could lead to that buildup. But either way, if you're a short-term player, kind of like we are at the Trading Analyst, that you can play these moves, you know, within this range. So I think that if we break the lows of today, I think it's going to head lower. And we've got nice support down here at about, you know, 975 to about 970 is that near-term support for Google that we could want to test before eventually breaking over this resistance potentially. But we're going to take it one day at a time with this stock. The next one we're going to touch on is Apple. And Apple, I just want to point out, you know, we were bearish here once we broke this trend line, and since this heavy volume selling day, and then that day was confirmed by a gap down right here, and that's where we really turned bearish on this stock. Watch the videos we did here in the middle of September, you know, September 13th and September 14th. You'll see that we were talking about Apple heading lower, and even I think I touched on it, you know, on this day as well, on the 8th. I've been saying that Apple was going to head lower, and we got a really nice move lower. So really congrats if you followed along. And just to kind of review why we liked it, and I think it's important to kind of touch on, you know, the reason why, so that you can learn from this. I'm not just going to show you, oh yeah, we said Apple was going lower, and that's it, because you really can't learn from that. The reason why we liked Apple for lower is because of a couple of reasons. We had this resistance there. We broke over that resistance. All right, looked like a nice breakout right there, but then it ended up breaking back below it. So this made it a false breakout right here. And to me, that wasn't enough to really, you know, I definitely was cautious at this point, and I thought that most likely Apple was going to get lower. But I really gained confidence on that move once we had a clear shot at breaking back over on this day right there, and it ended up being a heavy volume bearish engulfing day with heavy volume. I guess I already said it was heavy volume, but so that's the reason why. And right here, we're just coming into this resistance here. It was previous support. You can see the lows right there, and right here, about 4 days in a row hitting that level, and then we just gap below that level. So you can clearly see this 158 level is definitely a level of resistance. You can see we're hitting that high right here on Apple. Clearly see it reacting to that level. It's also the 50-day moving average. That red line is matching up perfectly with that angle as well. So to me, you know, the move here on Apple is somewhat underwhelming, really in either direction. You know, to be honest, it's looking a little weak at the moment. You know, obviously we had our short play over here. We thought Apple was going to head lower, but right here, you know, to me it's more of a no touch, and I'm leaning slightly bearish. I don't personally have a position, and you know, at this point I'm not personally going to initiate a position on this Apple, just because, you know, it's a little bit sloppy here, sideways. It's not really giving me much of a reason to take a position, but I do lean bearish on this stock just because, you know, it hasn't really made any kind of decent recovery from this drop right here. All the bounces have been pretty underwhelming. So we'll see what happens, but pay attention to these main levels. Next one we're going to take a look at is Twitter. Twitter, to me, this looks like it's headed higher. We broke over the resistance that we had right here. We've been pointing this level out for some time. And you can clearly see it's a resistance level. Not only that, but we broke out on some pretty nice volume. If you watch the videos that I was showing you in the past on Twitter, you know that we were kind of looking for that volume to step in. And we finally got that volume. You can see this is the biggest volume day since the big earnings gap down right here. So I definitely think that Twitter can see a nice move higher, at least to fill this gap up here at about 1950, which is about a dollar higher than where we're at right now. The next one we're going to take a look at is GoPro. And GoPro, not much has changed on this stock. I definitely think that, you know, this isn't the time, well, as far as my style and what I like to do, this isn't the time to initiate a new short position. If you've been following along, you know, we like GoPro for a short once it broke back under this resistance. So you can see it was previous resistance there, right here, and then right here on this day before eventually breaking over, and it looked bullish, kind of got a bounce here and broke back over it. But then we had this break back below this resistance. You know, this is not what you want to see And you can clearly see it has reacted since getting that false breakout right there. So that's definitely a setup that you want to keep in your toolbox here, is the false breakout or the false breakdown. You know, it really doesn't matter which one that you're looking at. You know, kind of looking at back here previously, what we saw on GoPro, here was a false breakdown. Here was that support level there, 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 here, and then finally we broke below it, and then we broke back over it right here, and you can see that led to a big, huge breakout moving forward on GoPro. So do not ignore this false breakout because it can lead to a swift move in the opposite direction. So if we get some kind of a pop-up to anywhere 1050, that's a good short area, all the way up to $11. I think it's going to come down here and at least fill this gap at about $8.95. The next one we're going to take a look at is Netflix. And Netflix is really simple here. Very bullish stock. You know, this is at all-time highs. It broke out to all-time highs on heavy volume. You can see that volume right here on these few days right there. That's very bullish. And you can see on these sideways red days, the volume really dropped off, and that's exactly what you want to see. So now this level is a level of support, right around 189.50 from that previous resistance level right there. So if we do head down to that level, it's going to be a nice bounce zone. Next one we're going to touch on is Priceline. Priceline, you can clearly see we're into this gap. Here's the gap right here, and we broke over it the other day right here. You can clearly see now it's using this level as a level of support. 1908, we've been mentioning that level. We hit it the other day, so congrats if you got in on that. We're already $10 higher from that. I think it looks like Priceline wants even higher than where we're at right now, based off of being over this resistance and turning it into support. So thank you for stopping by and watching the video, everyone. Again, if you're not already a member at thetradinganalyst.com, visit us on the homepage and then sign up for the premium membership. As soon as you sign up and join, you're going to get instant access to the profitable trade alerts that our current members are getting and loving on a daily and weekly basis. It's a great opportunity, and we'd love to start helping you make winning trades in the market.